Now, the past 72 hours have been very difficult for Texas Senator Ted Cruz. The first reason is, of course, the fact that Texas, the state that he represents, is experiencing some of the worst winter conditions in the history of Texas. And unfortunately, these severe ice storms have left millions of Americans without heat, electricity, and even drinking water. Take a look at this video. This is outside a public park in the city of Houston. And again, this is not a third world country. This is the United States of America. And people are lining up to get drinking water simply because everything's frozen. Even running water is not available right now in places in Texas. And it is so cold in America that there are literally American citizens that are dying in their beds at night because of the temperatures being too cold. The most extreme case that we've seen, an 11-year-old boy who passed away in the evening from hypothermia while sleeping in his mobile home. Now, events like this is, of course, very sad and just a tragedy. And of course, when something bad like this happens, it's very important for politicians to really step their game up and to make sure that they are there for the people that they represent. We need immediate action from local politicians and the United States government. Unfortunately, what we've seen from Ted Cruz is the exact opposite. Now, don't get me wrong, I'm frustrated. None of us can travel right now. It's a global pandemic. Of course, all of us in the cold weather destinations, we would love to be in a very sunny destination, maybe somewhere like the Ritz-Carlton Resort in Cancun, Mexico, which is exactly where Ted Cruz brought his family. Again, Ted Cruz decided to leave Texas at its most vulnerable time because he wanted to have a holiday. And don't get me wrong, I understand. His kids said, look, you know, Dad, I don't like it here. It's cold. Our house is freezing. Let's get out of here. I understand that. But the reality is that if you are a public servant, if you are serving the United States government, and you are representing a state and a group of people, you are a public figure. It is your job to serve the people. And unfortunately, we can just see that Ted Cruz's actions speak much louder than his words. And these actions, in my opinion, simply mean that he does not care for the very people that he represents. Now, many of you know that I vlog about China, and I actually had this thought to myself. What if Ted Cruz was actually a government official from China? How would his actions be perceived by the one-party state in China and Chinese citizens? I took to Twitter to share my thoughts. If Ted Cruz was a politician in China, his actions would have led to an immediate removal of office. If China had freezing like Texas, it would reallocate technicians and supplies from every province and immediately fix the problem. Ted Cruz failed Texas. It's time for him to resign. Now, I want to address the second point that I sent out in this tweet, that if China were in fact to experience a dramatic freeze like Texas is doing right now, that they would find a way to immediately solve the problem. And in fact, I actually have a very valuable case study that I would like to present to you to really help you understand how China's government is able to tackle these problems like this. In February 2008, I was living in Shanghai, China. And that Chinese New Year, there was an unprecedented ice and winter storm that wreaked havoc all over Shanghai and southern China. Now, this is a photo outside my residential complex in Shanghai, and you can see the snow is everywhere. Notice the red lanterns on this post. Again, this was Chinese New Year 2008, and we had over 2.5 feet of snow. Now, the city of Shanghai barely ever received snow, and you can just see how cold it was. Notice the trees, they're completely frozen over. Now, at the time, I was working for a golf academy. You can see the entrance to the building here, and this is the golf range where I was working. Again, everything is frozen. Even tropical climates like Guangzhou, that are normally very warm year-round, experienced rapid snowfall. And the worst part is that this was during Chinese New Year, a time where literally hundreds of millions of Chinese are transporting around the country, usually by trains. And what happened was, in the most extreme cases, there were some trains that were literally in the middle of nowhere, stuck on the tracks, without electricity, with tens of thousands of people inside, with no electricity, no food, and no supplies. This was a very dire time for the country of China, and something had to be done. And this is how China responded. Like I mentioned, China started relocating technicians from around the country, and they immediately started to work on fixing power grids, exactly like the one that you see here. In addition to that, they also sent in the People's Liberation Army to start clearing the roads and start rescuing the people. Now, the reason that I bring up China's government and how they responded to the ice storm in 2008 is I just want to give everybody a little bit more context. Because you see, in China, when a natural disaster, whether it's an ice storm or an earthquake or even COVID-19 like we saw in the city of Wuhan last year, the one-party state can move very fast and very efficiently to immediately solve and eradicate the problem. Again, one of the best case studies was last year in Wuhan when the Chinese government built two brand new hospitals in the span of 10 days and reallocated technicians, medical workers, and supplies from every province in China and sent them all to Wuhan to immediately tackle the problem. And this leads me to my next point, where accountability for your government officials is also extremely important. Let's go back to Wuhan last year and see what happened when local government officials were not doing their job. For context, Wuhan went into a lockdown on January 23rd, 2020. Hubei province and Wuhan city's top leaders were sacked on February 13th, 2020, and more competent people were transferred from Shanghai and Jinan. Mayor of Wuhan also resigned after the outbreak. Now, this is a very important point that I wanted to bring up and why I asked the question, if Ted Cruz was a government official in China, how would his actions be perceived? Well, again, the first thing is that Ted Cruz would be removed from office. Because China's system is really based on meritocracy. Meritocracy simply means that you must produce results, and only the best people in their prospective positions will be able to advance to the next level. In order to become the president of China, you must start at the bottom and work your way up to the top. And that is how everybody within China's one-party state advances their career. Simply put, if you have what it takes to make it, you are going to rise. You cannot fake it in China's system. You must produce results. If you do not, you will be removed and somebody else that is more competent and more efficient will be brought in. Now, I want everybody to be very clear. The purpose of this video is not to tell you that China's system is great and America's system is bad. I believe that both systems are actually very good and both of them have great qualities. But there is one thing that I really want, and I would like America to start learning from other countries. I do believe that there are some things America can learn from China, and one of the things that I would propose is that we learn accountability. That is the one thing that is within China's government that I think is a great characteristic trait we could take from China's system and actually apply it to America's. Because again, in China, you are held accountable for your actions. In the democratic system, it is simply just a popularity contest. And this is why politicians will say whatever they can in order to get elected. They do not have the best interest of the people at their hearts. Their entire focus as a politician in America is to get your vote. Now, one of the best examples that we've seen from Ted Cruz himself is his stance on the people of Hong Kong. Take a look at his personal website from November 2019 when he stated that America will always stand with the people of Hong Kong. However, 1 year later, Ted completely changed his stance and now states America should block people from Hong Kong because they could potentially be spies from Beijing. Now, I think the worst situation about this entire Cancun ordeal and Ted Cruz is the fact that he shows very little integrity. He left Texas in his most vulnerable time and tried to justify his actions because he has a child. And of course, this action led to becoming a meme that was very popular on Twitter. But the biggest thing that I really want people to take away from this video is that we need to start making a change in America and we need to start holding these politicians accountable. Now, one of the events that really rocked America 16 years ago was Hurricane Katrina. This hurricane devastated the city of New Orleans, as you can see from this aerial footage, and unfortunately, thousands of Americans lost their lives due to some very poor mismanagement from FEMA, the Federal Emergency Management Agency, and the United States government. But here's the saddest part. 16 years later, it seems that nothing has changed. Texas power crisis has turned into a disaster that parallels Hurricane Katrina. Take a look at this Bloomberg article, energy crisis in Texas is similar to Hurricane Katrina. 16 years later, the United States government is still making the same mistakes, and it's because we are not holding these politicians accountable. But I guess it makes sense because if we look at the actions of Ted Cruz, we can see that Ted Cruz actually voted against Hurricane Sandy federal relief in 2017. It seems that Ted Cruz doesn't really like helping out the people that he isn't put in charge to serve. Take a look at this report where some Texans are now paying up to $450 a day for their electricity because this is what's happening in America. We have a system based on the individual, and Ted Cruz's actions prove that the individual is more important than the society, and this is something that needs to change in America. Many of you who follow this channel know that I am very passionate about two countries, the United States and China, and I always advocate that the two countries need to learn to work together. This is one example of something that I believe the United States could learn from China. And of course, there's many things that China could learn from the United States as well, but one very simple element, accountability, holding your politicians accountable. This is what happens in China, and this is what needs to happen in America if we are going to start seeing the change. Or else, what's going to be the next federal disaster that is going to cost American lives? Everybody, I want to thank you for watching this YouTube channel. If you've made it to this point and you're not already subscribed, hit that subscribe button, drop me a comment down below, and check out our links in the description on how you can be a member of our team and help this channel grow even faster. Everyone, thank you for your continued support, and we'll see you in the next video.